Good morning, guys. This is Pastor Chris from True Life Way. God is on the move, and that's what we're going to be talking about today. It's God is up to something. No, Christopher. The other song. I'm going to sing you a song today, and it's called Enemy's Camps, and I think sometimes we need to go back and take back what the devil took from us in the beginning. So, Christopher, you go ahead and press play on that song for me. Turn it up a little bit. Okay. Well, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. Well, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. He's under my feet, he's under my feet. He's under my feet, well, he's under my feet. He's under my feet, he's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Well, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. Well, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. He's under my feet, he's under my feet. He's under my feet, well, he's under my feet. He's under my feet, he's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Well, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. Well, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me. He's under my feet, he's under your feet. He's under my feet, well, he's under my feet. He's under my feet, he's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Satan is under your feet.
You gotta claim it today.
Satan is under my feet.
Amen. Amen. He is under my feet. Do not let Satan steal your joy this morning. Do not.
But I want to go over a few things real quick. For Celebrate Freedom's coming up. And we would like as many of you to go with us as possible. It'll be a great time for meeting up and fellowshipping one with another in the Lord. It will take place on Saturday, September 2nd, 2017. It's located at Jim R. Miller Park in Marietta, Georgia. Free admission. Parking is $5 and with a ticket. It's $15 without a ticket. And starting August 7th, tickets will be free at Ingles, so all you gotta do is run by Ingles, grab your ticket, you knock $10 off your parking. Some of the guys that's gonna be there singing is gonna be Mercy Me, Crowder, Zach Williams, and there's a whole lot more. If you want more details on this, you can go to celebratefreedom.com, and everything's there that you need. And we will work out the smaller details on if we have enough people wanting to go with us to meet up, or if we just meet up there at Jim R. Miller Park. But it's in September. We've still got some time to plan and, you know, make preparations for that. So we'll work out the smaller details. Yeah. I also, something else I want to start doing is actually taking up live prayer requests. And Whitney's going to help me because I have Facebook in front of me, but I don't want to actually view my own video live because I don't want to mess up the signal and all. So if you have any if you have any prayer requests, you can comment them now. Whitney's going to let me know. I'm going to write them down. We'll pray over them. So I'm going to give you just a few minutes to, if you have any. I don't know how many's watching right now. So, yeah. Anyways, we haven't anybody post anything yet, Whitney?
No.
No? Okay. But if you do have prayer requests, you can always comment on there, and we will pray over them.
Or message.
Message us, call, you know, whatever. We'll. It's never a bad time to pray for anybody.
Angela said to please pray for her family.
And a priest, okay. Please pray for
Angela Neve.
Neve family.
And Junior. Preacher Junior Harrison.
Okay.
Said pray for the Bowen family and the Hall family.
Bowen and who?
Hall.
Hall family. Okay. Does anybody else? Anybody else have a prayer request before we move on? Boys? My sound man?
Yeah.
You have a prayer request? What is it? Yes. Carson has a prayer request. He pointed at us, so I guess he wants to pray for our family.
I guess with school starting back. The teachers
and
the Barrow
County school system will be starting back
Newton started Friday.
Wednesday. And so we'll go ahead and pray for the kids starting in Barrow County, and we'll also, I know Newton County already started, and was it Friday you said?
Mm-hmm.
So we'll just do a collective prayer over them, over this school year.
Walton starts, I don't know.
Can't wait.
We'll just pray for all the kids when they go back. So.
Teachers too.
Prayer
teachers
for too. Students and teachers, very good.
And
okay.
Mom.
All right, well, I guess we're going to move on. So we're going to take these needs before the Lord. Because we know the same God that was here yesterday, today, and forever. We know He's the same God. The ones that was hit doing the miracles back in the day, still doing miracles today, and He never changes. So the same God we serve, they served back then, same God we serve today, and we're going to move on with the prayers. So, Lord, we come to You right now, God. I ask that You just touch the Angela Nave's family, Lord, that You be with them, God, whatever the situation may be, Lord. You know more than we do, God, and we ask that You just come in, touch them where You see fit, and according to Your will and purpose. God, we also ask that You be with the Bowen and Hall family today, God, that You'll touch them and be with them, give them strength and comfort, God. And Lord, we also ask that You just touch all the students and teachers of Newton County, Walton County, Barrow County, Georgia, all across this nation, all across the world, God, wherever they go to school, that You'll be with them, God, that You'll give them strength and let them be able to go through it, God. I also ask today, God, that You let this be a seed planted in someone's life, that we will always know that when it seems like we are down to nothing, that You are up to something, that You've got something going on, God. And we ask this all in Your precious name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
So, today, as in the prayer you heard, I'm sure that we're going to be talking about that God is up to something. How many times have you been down and you feel like nothing's going the way it should, and you just feel like, God, where are You? Well, everybody feels that way sometimes, including me. It's like, well, God, why are You letting this happen? Why is this going on? I am down to nothing. Well, I always know that God is up to something. Our scripture is going to be Romans 8, verses 28. And it says, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to His purpose. I'm going to start off with a story. And it's kind of a crazy story, but it gets the point across. And I didn't write the story. I found this on Facebook a while back, but it says, let me get this up, because I'm about blind as a bat. One Sunday morning at a small southern church, the new pastor called on one of his older deacons to lead in the opening prayer. The deacon stood up, bowed his head, and said, Lord, I hate buttermilk. The pastor opened one eye and wondered where this was going. The deacon continued, Lord, I hate lard. Now the pastor was totally perplexed. The deacon continued, Lord, I ain't too crazy about plain flour. But after you mix them all together and bake them up in a hot oven, I just love biscuits. Lord, help us to realize when life gets hard, when things come up that we don't like, whenever we don't understand what You are doing, that we need to wait and see what You are making. After you get through mixing and baking, it'll probably be something even better than biscuits. Amen. I've told that story before to some teenagers, but, there's a lot of things You take these three ingredients that I said, what was it? Lard, flour. I mean, yeah, this stuff by itself, yeah, nothing. But when you mix it together, you put it together, it makes something great. Something most people like, you know, biscuits. So it's really good. And in life, sometimes it's hard to understand why things happen the way they do. We know in life there are some hills we are going to have to climb. There are some valleys we will have to descend into. There are some storms we will have to face, some battles we will have to fight. But never during these times are we alone. That God is with us and God loves us, and we just have to trust Him and hold on to His promises. He is always up to something. As the story above says, buttermilk, lard, and flour. They may not be good on its own, but when you mix them together, it becomes something that we all love. Biscuits. It's great, you know? And sometimes we have storms and trials that come our way, and if we never had a problem, I want you to think about this. If we never encountered a problem as a Christian, how would we know to trust God? How would we be able to know, well, I've gone through the storm. God's brought me through one before. How would we know what God could do if we never went through anything? If you never had to fight a battle, if you never had to, I don't know, maybe walk on water to Jesus. You remember in the story where Jesus was out there in water and he had told Peter, come out upon the water. And as soon as Peter turned his head, he started to sink into the water. That's how we are. But if we don't know, if we don't go through things, we will never know what God's capable of. We as Christians, if we don't know, what could we do? It would be mighty hard for me to get behind the camera or anywhere and try to tell somebody what Jesus can do. And like, what has He brought you through? Well, if I'd never gone through anything, I wouldn't be able to convince anybody that Jesus does anything for anyone. And like a lot of people, I've gone through many things. Me and my wife have gone through things. And it's because of the things we go through that makes us who we are today. You know, being a Christian, being able to depend on God to see us through things. A strong Christian won't so easily be defeated. It doesn't mean we won't fall. It doesn't mean we won't, you know, come short sometimes. But in our weakness, God's strength is made perfect. He will fight the battle for us. Now, I want to tell you a little bit about a story that some people know and some people don't know. And Whitney's going to chime in. She's going to help me out with telling this story. But it happened to us one time where we were living with her father. I was living with my father-in-law. We were staying there just for a short time because things got rough. We had to go through some things. We faced things that we didn't want to face. And so we had to do what we had to do. So we move in there, and it wasn't the best of situations. It wasn't great, and I'm not going to bash anybody. We was thankful to have a place to stay at the time, but in that moment, we knew it wasn't good for us. It wasn't good for our children. I was still having to drive an hour to work. You know, that's just one way at the time, one way, an hour to work. And Whitney and I was like, something's got to give. It's got to give. We can't continue like this. And so we, one morning, didn't know Whitney prayed. She didn't know I prayed. But we had a very similar prayer, and it was for God to get us out, to change something. Lord, we're down to nothing. Something's got to give. I know that you're up to something. But we didn't know what. Okay? And so we both said that prayer. We weren't together. I didn't know she said it. She didn't know I'd said it. But later on that night, things started to happen. Things started to change. Things we didn't have any control over that we didn't know that was going to happen. It turned out that a service wire coming into the home was out of code. It wasn't up to code, and it was very old. And with us being upstairs in the house, we had AC run, a window unit running, and it just overheated and caught fire. Okay, so now you've got smoke everywhere. It's so hot, burning. And what ended up happening was the fire department got called out, put the fire out. But it turned out to be they wouldn't turn the electricity back on until the service wire was replaced. Back up to code, obviously. They're not going to... let's turn the power back on, even though the wire just caught fire. So, being upstairs, you know, heat rises, okay? So, it was much hotter upstairs than it was downstairs in the living room. There was no possible way that Whitney and I, my family, my boys, we could stay up there in that room upstairs. It was just way too hot. There was nothing we could do. We couldn't stay there.
It was in the summer.
It was, yeah, so that's a good point. It was during the summertime. So it was extremely hot. And there was just no way. So we went from a moment where we had a place to stay, maybe not good conditions, but we had a place to stay, to we were homeless at this point. Okay, we had no place to go to call our home, okay? So we ended up, I ended up calling my grandmother. Well, before I called my grandmother, I actually called up at my job where I work now, and they told the guy there at the time, like, look, I'm not coming in tomorrow. The house we were in caught fire, and pretty much told him I didn't know where we was going to sleep that night. I had no idea. And we really didn't, Whitney. If you can back me up on that. We didn't know exactly where we was going to go. Because at this point, I hadn't called anybody. But then I called my grandmother, and they agreed to let us stay there a couple days. I think we was there for like two nights, whatever it was. And so now we have a place to stay. It still is not a place to call home. I mean, we're still nowhere to go. All right. But we have a place to stay at least. Thank God. I mean, he moved in and he gave us a place to stay. Okay, well, Whitney starts looking, trying to find a place closer to Winder to get hired. Because this is where I work. I work in Winder. I needed a house close by. And so she starts looking in the, I guess, the paper, internet, whatever it was. I don't remember. But she's looking. And the house we live in today, do you believe it or not, this house was not listed. It was not even listed for rent. She happened to stumble across the number. Was that what happened with
me? Mm-hmm. It was a different house.
It was a totally different house. A much more expensive house, I believe, wasn't it?
No,
it was cheaper. Yeah. Well, still, though. Anyways, the house... But the point is, this house was not even listed, okay? Move that mouse, Christopher, so the screen will go. But we ended up, God showing us, giving us this house we live in. And no, it's not like the grandest of mansions. It's not the house on the hill. But you know what? The house we're living in, it's not in the valley. It doesn't flood when it rains. And it's not overly expensive. We can afford where we live. Do you know, when we lived in Oxford, when we lived in Oxford and Covington area, we couldn't afford to hardly make ends meet. It was so bad, which is what led up to us moving in with her dad to begin with, because bills were so much. I could not afford it. We lived in some apartments over there in Oxford. Our light bill would be easily $300 a month. That's not including what we already owed from the past month or two. We got so behind, it wasn't funny. But that's just how things happen. I consider us to be pretty good people, but sometimes things happen to good people. And it doesn't mean that you done something to cause it to happen, okay? But when we became when we fell to rock bottom, when we were down to nothing, God had something up his sleeve. He had something planned. Because the way things work with God, he sees the whole picture. We may see bits and pieces here and there, but he knows from the beginning how it's going to play out, what pieces needs to go where, just like we talked about Wednesday night, putting the puzzle piece together. Let God put the pieces in where they need to go. Keep our hands off of it. We need to learn how to, you know, we have our own way of saying, like, Lord, you know, I really like this. Well, we need to get our will out of the way and let his will be done. It's not about what we want. It's about his will. And when his will becomes, when his will is done, it's just perfect. It works for the best for everyone. Okay? And so, I want to move on. I also want to tell you about not letting things of your past dictate your future. There's a lot of people I've talked to that they think that I'm just a nobody. I've done some wretched things in my past. I've done this. I've done that. I've even had people tell me, if you knew what some of the things I had done in the past, you probably wouldn't want to be my friend. You probably wouldn't want to talk to me. I don't care what you did in your past. It ain't about what you've done. It's about what you're doing now. What you've done in the past, that's over with. You can become a new creature in Christ. You can be somebody totally different. And you don't need to let that be saying, well, since I've done this and I've done that, God could never possibly love me like he would love somebody else. God has no respecter of persons. He loves you just like he loves the, what's a not good example, Whitney? He loves you just like he loves the pastor of a church, for instance, all right? And I'm going to go ahead and tell you like it is now. No pastor in any church is any better than the lowest member of the congregation. And when I say lowest, I mean maybe the ones that doesn't really know what they're, just stepping into it, don't really know. Pastors know better. Singers are no better. I'm the same as you. I'm the same as my kids. I'm no better than the rest of them. You know, because we all sin, but we all sin a little bit differently. And it's not up to me to tell you, well, since you've done this, you're never going to heaven. That's not any of my business. That's between you and God. But don't let things of your past keep you from moving forward either. He loves you, and he loves me, that he died on a cross. And you're like, well, you said something about that last time, that he died on a cross for everybody's sin. We get it. But do you get it? Do you really get it? He died on the cross for me, my kids, you. He died for the drunkard. He died for the homosexual. He died for all the sins, okay? He died for every single one of them. He died so we can be saved. We can have freedom in Christ Jesus. Eternal life. Well, I just don't know. I mean, I'm the bottom of the barrel, Pastor. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter where you come from, who you are, what you've done. You have, anyways, the Bible says to enter in the gates of heaven, you have to be born again. You have to be a born again Christian. So the old you has to go away. It has to die because you have to be reborn. You have to be a new person, a new creature in Christ. The Bible says, and so. Well, how do you become a new creature in Christ? Well, we're going to get to that. But one of the things is you have to put your faith and trust in God. And then Acts 2:38, Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Well, I'm scared of a ghost. Not this ghost. This Holy Ghost is God's Spirit dwelling within you. Baptized in Jesus' name. I've been baptized. I was, back when I was a kid. I have an issue with baptizing young children just because they don't necessarily know why they're being baptized. I was baptized back when in 94, 93, 94, something like that. And then growing up and then once I become an adult, I was like, well, yeah, I was baptized a long time ago, but then I still felt like there was something missing. Like something wasn't right. And it was because after I become a man, I realized, I understood truly what baptism means, why we get baptized, and why we don't just get baptized every other weekend just because we want to. So, I feel like baptism is very important. And yes, I'm not going to go into a whole lesson on Holy Ghost and baptism. We will get to that. But that's what we have to do. We have to become a new creature. And being repentance. What is repentance? That's turning away from your sin. Not continuing to do the same things. Well, I'm tempted, Pastor. I understand that we're all tempted. It means we're not willfully going out there and just continuously doing the same stuff we once did. I used to be a bad person. Okay? Repent. Turn from it. And once you turn from it, don't look back on it. When you're tempted, what do I do when I'm tempted? Pray. Because what happened then doesn't make you who you are today. You can be a new person, a new creature in Christ. Because Jesus died for every one of us. And it's not right for any of us to get in a church building or anywhere and say, well, they're not going to make it heaven. That is none of your business. You love them like Christ and you lead them to Jesus. Don't sit there and tell them you're going to hell because of this and that and that and that. None of your business. I know that's getting kind of harsh and it's getting rough in here, but that's just the way things are.
You can't love someone and always criticize what they do. I'm sorry, you're not perfect. None of us are perfect. But with that being said, I just want to thank you, Christopher. If you want, don't mind, go ahead and get that next song playing.
I see a shadow.
With that being said, with all the stuff we just talked about, you don't have to walk the same way, the same walk you've been walking. You don't have to continue down that same path. You can be a new creature. But it, like I said last time and every other time, it's up to you to make that decision. Nothing can stop God from loving you. You may get separated by us. Sin may separate the way you towards Him, but He still loves you. And just know that. Don't let the haters hate you. Don't let them say, well, you'll never make it. Because I'm telling you today that you can make it, and you will make it if you trust in Jesus and continue to walk His path and pursue Him. Lord, I thank you for this day, God. I thank you, Lord, for everything that you've done. I thank you, Lord, for all that you're going to do, Jesus. Lord, I ask that you let this message be a seed planted in somebody, God, that it may grow forth, Lord, and bring forth good fruit, Jesus. God, I ask you just let them realize the ones that are downtrodden, the ones that feel like they're nothing, God. They may have been told that all their lives, God, but they are somebody in you, Jesus. And when we are down to nothing, God, Lord, we thank you for you being up to something, God. We know that our storms and our trials, they only last for a season, Lord. And it's because of those storms and trials that we can become who we are today, God. That we can be strong, Lord, in you, Jesus. God, I just thank you, Lord, for everything. And I love you, Jesus. And God, I just ask that you just touch each and every one of them, God. Everybody that can hear my voice, Lord, is under the sound of my voice, Jesus. You are with them. And you love them, Jesus. And remember that. Amen, God. And He died for all of us. Just like the song says, there's nothing too dirty that He can't make worthy. You wash me in mercy, I am clean. That could be you today. But like I said, you have to pursue it. You have to be the one to take action and go forth. But I want to thank you for watching this. And as mentioned before, if you have any more prayer requests, message them to us, text us, call us, whatever. It doesn't matter. We'll pray for you. We'll pray with you. And that's all I can say. We love you. And we hope you have a great day. God bless. God bless.